on the Snake River in Wyoming as a river guide. And so for many, many years after that, I always would return there in my mind. And I imagined a wedding taking place on the river instead of a church, just this very young couple, romantic, madly in love. And instead of a regular wedding, they decide they'll get married on the banks of the river and then finish the wedding and push off in a raft and float off into happily ever after. And typically the woman, well, I wanted one romantic and one realist. And typically the woman would be the romantic and the man would be the realist. And I thought, nah. And so the characters kind of took off from there. He doesn't want to have rings. He wants to just have a romantic ceremony where they put their fingers into the river and hold each other's hands to join the cycle of the water. And when they do it, the water's freezing. And she thinks, why are we, what's wrong with a ring? And so the couple stayed with me. And maybe 10 years later, I wondered what happened to them. And so I wanted a story of their lives together. And instead of doing, you can't do it just a happy love story because it's boring if every day's perfect. So I had to put something in their way that would make it more difficult to test their relationship. When they first started to take shape on the page, her voice was, to me, very engaging. And she's smart, she's tough, she's funny, and Dalt is pretty steady. And so I thought she would be the better narrator because her take would have highs and lows, and Dalt was just even. So I definitely wanted to go with the wilder of the two of them. At the beginning of the story, they're both so young and so strong, and she takes such pride in her strength in being able to run with the boys and hit the biggest, hardest rapids in the rafts. And so when I thought, I want to make something that will challenge them and test them, MS would be a way to steal her strength. And that's who she is, it's a big part of who she is. And so it would not only test her, but then it would test the relationship too. And the idea that, well, MS was a good disease because I could make it last through their lives and have a gradual deterioration, which is also a way to make the story much more universal than just this couple on a river. It's really just taking what age does to all of us and shrinking it down. And so making a story that anyone could relate to who's watched people age, and so in her case, it's foreshortened, which turns up the tension in the book. Well, I've been to France many times, but never to Marseille. So as soon as we stepped out of the train station, wow, this is fabulous. And in Montana, where I live, we've got mountains and rivers, and it's ridiculously beautiful, but we don't have the sea. So coming here is a beautiful day. This might not be the answer, but over here, talking about this book, I was often asked about not why I wrote from a woman's point of view, but you know, how do I write such a strong woman character? And day after day, I started to think, well, that's an odd question, because all the women I know are like, they're acting as if strong women were a scarce thing. And I think they're all over the place. So I didn't think it was an unusual choice. And so that's a question that I've been asked, and finally said, well, I never thought of that.